Morning, Stampers. It is Friday, and you are watching Maker Mornings with Meg from my LovenStamps channel. So welcome. I'm glad you're here. Today, usually when I do a card and I happen to be wearing something that coordinates, I always say, oh no, it was just a coincidence, because it really is. But today, not a coincidence. Today, I put on my pirate shirt. Here you go. Tanya, I know you're a big Disney fan. My Disney pirate shirt. Oh, in the back. There you go. And I thought, oh, you know what? Today I'm going to make a pirate card. So we are all deliberate today about making a pirate card to match my pirate shirt. But more importantly, I know you guys are, you know, maybe you have your pirate shirts on today. But more importantly, we're going to go through kind of the process of card design, because often there are a lot of twists and turns along the way. So it's kind of like following a treasure map. It's where X marks the spot, you know, for a pot of gold or something. But today X marks the spot for the finished card design that we really like. And there's a number of different things that I did when I was putting this card together that I tried and I thought, it's not quite right, what's wrong? And then tweaked it to come up with something a little different. So we're gonna run through those kind of together so that I can explain, because I love when people say that they feel like they understand so much more about how to design their own cards. So, and of course, if you are not into designing your own cards, then you know there's lots of ideas here on my Love and Stamps channel, and certainly you're welcome to use any of them. So that's why I put them out there. Morning, guys. Hey, Kay and Teresa and Deborah and Tanya and Elaine and everybody. Okay. Hey, Jenny. All right, I'm gonna flip you guys down this direction and we're gonna get started with our treasure map of card design. So, all right. And in case you missed it, yes, I have on a pirate shirt. So we're all like decked out for theme day here. It's Friday. Okay, so we're gonna use the Pirates and Mermaids stamp set, which I did use one time before on a video. I didn't put the link in the video description for this card, but I can go back and add it. We did sort of the we did blended alcohol technique on this. So here's the mermaid version with those fun diorama dies. But today we're gonna use the pirate. So we're gonna go ahead and get him stamped here. And you can see I store all kinds of extras in my stamp cases. And then I usually leave that extra sticker sheet in there sort of as a barrier. So. That really helps. Oh, I already got him mounted. All right. That usually helps to kind of protect those pieces from any like stray ink that might still be sticking to those stamps. So I'm going to ink him up in Memento, and I always look at it to make sure I got a good amount of ink on there that he's going to stamp the way I want him. And then of course, with this stamp set, we need our little treasure chest. So I'm going to go ahead and add our treasure chest to our strip. Now, there aren't dies to cut these, so you'll need to use your paper snips to trim them, but really not a big deal, and it doesn't take a long time. They're pretty quick when you have really nice, sharp, detailed scissors. Somebody asked one time, can you sharpen those? And I'll show you here. This pair of snips has been sharpened. Can you see the tips don't quite meet there at the top? You can sharpen paper snips and keep using them. It's really nice to have sharp. You can't remount the screw on there, so they're not gonna quite meet at the tip. But you know what, not a big deal. Just don't cut to the very tip of your scissors, which you're not supposed to do anyway. okay, and so we can go ahead and just trim around these. And I like to leave sort of that little area of white right around the edges. And you can see I'm cutting pretty far back on my scissor blade. The reason you don't want to cut to the tip of your scissor blade is that often you'll get a tear in the paper there where the scissors come together and they just rip at the very end because they're forcing through where there's no cutting blades. So always a good plan to cut a little bit further back in your scissors. Kind of like in the kitchen when you're using a knife, use different parts of the blade for different techniques. I'm not really a chef though, so don't quote me on that. But I'm pretty sure, right? Don't you? I know I do. Okay, well, if there's any culinarily trained folks out there, you can comment on share some info with us on where you're supposed to cut with the blade of your knife. But anyway, different parts of the blade for different purposes. So same with paper snips. So you can see I'm just sort of going around here with some roundy edges. And then I left this part on the side here where with the white paper in there, I'm gonna go back and I'm going to remove just a little bit of that. So I'm gonna kind of curve around there. I'm not gonna worry about getting too far in. And then I'm gonna remove just a little bit of this one too. Okay. All right, there we go. Okay, so now we have our treasure. There's our happy birthday from our card. The other day, what did we make? Oh yeah, we made the die cut card with the die cut flowers. Okay, so I have my pirate ready. Now, on our pirate, I thought, you know what would be really fun? It would be really fun to use some of the planking paper, the wood boards from the In Good Taste Designer Series paper. This one is on sale only till the end of July. So I know some people are excited, they're waiting for Celebration, but don't miss out on the chance to get this one at the discounted price, especially because it's a double pack. It comes with 24 sheets, so your discount is even better. But I'm gonna take a piece of this paper and I'm gonna cut it to fit on our card front. So it's gonna be 5 1/4 inches wide. So I've got that here. And then I was thinking, well, what color do I want to do for background? And the color that I used when I did our card the other day, sorry about the squeaky noise, was a gray granite when we did our Quiet Meadow card. And I loved the way this paper really complemented this, or the cardstock really complemented the paper. So we're gonna go with that again. And I'm kind of picturing our pirate standing on our deck here. Okay, so he's gonna have sort of a scene. We're making a little scene here for our pirate. And remember, we're kind of following along. So the treasure map of finding the end point of our card and kind of adjusting and turning and different things along the way is sort of our strategy this morning. Okay, so now I thought, you know what? I feel like I need another element here. And a lot of times when I'm trying to figure out what element to add, I will look at the catalog samples for the stamp set. So this is page 58 in the catalog. And here's our Pirates and Mermaids stamp set. And I found this sample here. And I thought, oh my gosh, that's really cute. I love the little steering wheel, whatever you call it on a ship. I love the little steering wheel on there, and I want to add that to my card. So the steering wheel is from the Smooth Sailing dies, so they match the Sailing Home stamp set, which came out a couple years ago. And if you're looking for ideas on this, actually there are a ton on my blog with video tutorials, so you should check those out. But I decided to grab this little steering wheel, and I was gonna cut him out from some paper. And then I thought, you know what, there's paper that matches with more wood grain. So let's grab a light one and go ahead and die cut this to add to our card. So I've got my die cut ship steering wheel here. Okay, we can put those kind of together. And then what else do we need? We need some background to this. We need like what's off the edge of his ship. And so I thought, you know what? It would be really fun to have some waves. So let's bring in Misty Moonlight. And waves are not something that we currently have a specific die for, but that's okay because it's really easy to make your own waves. Now, usually I like to use a circle punch, but we're fresh out of circle punches right now. So this is where the ice cream cone builder punch comes in. And actually, I almost like it a little better because instead of having a circle here, it's a little bit more oval shaped. And so here's how we're gonna make our waves. We're gonna start our punch here and we're gonna punch along the edge and make sort of a semi, can you see where, there you go, a kind of a semicircle. And then I'm gonna kind of keep moving that across and try not to drop it every time. I'm gonna use just this portion of our ice cream, ouch, of our ice cream there so that it kind of gives us a little bit more of a wave effect. And then we'll do that. Okay, see how that works? So there are some waves that we can pop here behind our pirate ship. What do you guys think so far? We moving in the right direction? Okay, and then I thought, you know what? One set of waves doesn't really do it. Kind of we need two sets. So I've got another strip here of the Misty Moonlight cardstock, and I am punching some more waves. And this one's quite a bit narrower because we're gonna layer it together with the one that we already have. Okay, we got one giant wave there at the end. All right, so we can put this in front of or behind. Let's see, we'll tuck this there. Now when we mount this, I think what we'll do is we'll put some Stampin' dimensionals kind of between these, and I'll show you when we get to that part, so that you can get sort of the effect. And actually, the waves need to be, the water has to be flat behind, so I'm gonna, there we go, turn that around. Okay, so you guys with me so far? So now we have our pirate, he's standing on the deck, he's got a little steering wheel, and then we're going to need a background. So then I thought, you know what, if this is kind of like a great little, you know, a young card for a young pirate fan, then maybe I would stick with the blues. And what if we put in a piece of balmy blue here to be sort of the skyline behind our card? Okay. All right. So here's kind of our card layout. And I will tell you that this is not what we're going to stay with, but I'm going to leave it for here for now. Okay. And then we're going to come back to this, and I'm going to tell you what I don't like about the way this looks. Okay, says the wheel is called the helm. Yes, the helm. Thank you. Whew, glad we have some nautical friends among us this morning. Okay, so while we're thinking about how this is going to change, I'm going to bring these back here. I'm taking them off because I want to bring in my Stampin' Blends. I'm going to use my light crumb cake marker, and we're going to give our pirate here some skin tone color. You, of course, can color whatever skin tone you like. And his little hands are down here where he's holding his sword. Cutlass, I think, or something like that is what it's called. Oh, I didn't cover above his eye patch. There we go. Okay, and then clearly we need some gold because we have treasure. So this is Daffodil Delight, and I'm gonna color his treasure. I'm doing sort of, and the little clasps here on our treasure thing, and then his sword, we'll give that. And his little, I think this pirate is a very classy dude. He has gold trim on his jacket. Okay. All right, and then I'm gonna give that just a little bit more highlighting because I want that gold to be just a little bit stronger. And I'm gonna just dab some kind of darker gold in there. And I think I'm gonna go over his belt buckle and his cutlass. All right, so now what colors are we going for here? Well, we picked Misty Moonlight for the background, which means I'm gonna stick with Misty Moonlight and mirror that color here on his little dungarees. So this is the lighter of the Misty Moonlight. When you have a really dark Stampin' Blend, sometimes I stick with the lighter one, especially if the dark's not gonna show up a ton anyway. And then I thought, okay, oh, here, we use the crumb cake to do our, oh, I didn't color the gold that's on the ground there. There's so much gold in this treasure chest that it's just spilling out everywhere. Okay, so let's go back and add that, grab the darker and just do little specks there. And I don't worry too much about coloring outside the line, kind of adds some extra texture to that. And his little peg leg here, gonna need to be crumb cake. All right, so now adding some color. What I thought would be really fun would be to use some of these jewels on the treasure. So we're going to bring this back in. I'm gonna use Poppy Parade then because they're a great match for our jewels. And I'm going to color his jacket here. So we've got his jacket now in red. He's looking pretty dapper here, I think. They're a dapper looking pirate. But we're going to kind of review our card design here because what I'm thinking is that he kind of floats a little bit on there. There's a lot of open ocean, which I suppose works in the reality of open oceans, but I want our design, our card design to be a little tighter. So I'm gonna go back, I'm gonna add a little dark along the edge of his coat, kind of where there's shadows, and then on those color hair lines and where his beard kind of overlaps. All right, so he has a little more dimension. All right, so you see what I mean? There's a lot of open space for our pirate, and I think we could do better. So One of the things that I really like is a 3x4 card design, where you have a panel in the middle that narrows things down. Here is an example from a paper pumpkin kit. This one I used a scallop edge, and I added this little element here in the background to really focus in the center. And I feel like we need to focus our pirate in. So instead of that large card, what if we bring him in and focus here on a piece of the balmy blue that's gonna focus our elements in, okay? So we still have a little strip of that wood planking paper, and we have a couple strips of waves, and I'm gonna tuck these under here, and we have our pirate, and we have our wheel and our treasure chest. Move those over. All right, do you see how, here, I'll show you the original one with a card background. Do you see how much better that works? We have a real like focal point now. We have a not like giant background where things are like, feel like they're missing. We have something that's just the right size for this, for the size of our card elements, okay? All right, so let's go ahead and start sticking these things down. So I'm gonna grab my seal. There we go. And kind of got that, I think my seal is gonna kind of go over the edge here. Okay, so I'm gonna pick this up with it. And then where I have a tiny bit on the edge, I'm gonna go ahead and trim because I don't want that to peek out. You could use your trimmer too. And then I'm gonna put this next layer of the waves on there, kind of keeping it in mind of where I want it to end up. There we go, okay. And then I'm gonna add one more set of adhesive to pop this whole, maybe one more here, pop this whole thing back down here on our card, okay. All right, so, oh, I meant to put dimensionals in there. Well, you know what? That's the great thing about mini dimensionals. We're just gonna pry up this edge here, and I'm going to pop a mini dimensional underneath there, and that is going to give us that layer between. Okay, all right, see how that works? So I'll give you a little closer. There we have the sort of that nicer shadow between our waves. Okay, let's see, Sue says, sizing the top card helps me. Yes. It really makes a difference, right? And I love to show the before and the after of that design element so you can really understand why it's better. Okay, so we're gonna stick our pirate back on here, and he is going to be on Stampin' Dimensionals because why not? So we'll pop him on, and then there he is, claiming his territory. And then he has his jewel case here. And I'm going to overlap the helm. Did you like that, Kay? There with, so I'm covering up that little hole there because I don't really want the hole to show. And I don't really want to have to like build the whole ship with the railings and stuff. So we're going to call this good enough. All right. But the thing that we have not gotten on here yet, two things, the greetings and the jewels. So let's bring the jewels in. And I'm going to use my take your pick tool with a putty tip to do the slide and stick technique. So slide and stick. And we clearly need a lot of treasure in here. I love the way these rhinestones really set off the gold in the background. Let's see there. Okay, isn't that the cutest thing? Okay, so we have our jewels, we have our pirate, we have our helm. We need a greeting here. So let's grab a piece of basic white cardstock, and I think on the front of our card, we're gonna use the Ahoy There Matey greeting. So go ahead and stamp this on a piece of basic white. We'll trim that down, and we get this. And I love the way this overlaps the edge of the card so that it, I could put it on here all together, but when we move it outside the edge of this rectangle, it kind of brings the whole, like the card background and the card front ground, I almost said, together. So let's bring those together like this. And I'm gonna pop some dimensionals on, and that's overlapping. Okay, so, and then we have an inside of our card. So let's bring in, I was gonna bring in a big piece of Whisper White, I mean basic white, to stamp inside, but instead, I can use a piece of our designer series paper since we have all those great sheets of different wood grains. We're gonna carry our wood grain into the center. And I've cut here from, this must be Mossy Meadow. I think in the video description, I said this was shaded spruce. It's Mossy Meadow, so that it's a nice fit here. And we're gonna add this to our card. So I've got my multi-purpose liquid glue here, and I'm gonna just put a little. Remember, if you're using this glue, you guys know what I always say, right? If you can see it, it's enough. You don't have to have a ton. And you really don't want it to splurge over the edges because it stays sticky for a long time. Okay, so that's gonna sit there. And then I'm going to bring back our greeting and we're gonna stamp, it's your birthday. So you could also use the punny greeting, you're a treasure, if you wanted, if this wasn't a birthday card, but I think it'd make a good birthday. Now, I don't wanna stamp this directly on here and have it be crooked, so I'm gonna do my test, which is what I was doing here. So I'm gonna line up my stamp where I think it's gonna stamp straight, and it pretty well does. So I feel pretty good about putting it on my card. If it wasn't stamping straight, then I would kind of tweak it and go a little bit of a, you know, I would look at how far and which direction was off, and then I would stamp it appropriately. Okay, so this is gonna go inside our card. Now, here's the big twist at the end of our treasure map. I was looking at this and I thought, wow, that's really fun. But it's a little drab for a young pirate fan. So I thought, what if I change the background color from the gray granite to Poppy Parade? Okay, what do you guys think? Poppy Parade or gray granite? Poppy Parade. Oh, Jenny's petting the puppy. Yes. So the reason that Pepper is whining is that a family of chipmunks, it was one at first and now it's a whole family, has moved into our back patio, and it really drives her crazy. And they sit and stare at her through the patio glass. Oh, chipmunks. Anyway, okay, Poppy Parade. Everyone is saying Poppy. Oh, Kim likes the gold and rubies, and Kim says, use the blue Stampin' Blends or white chalk. Yes, that would be super cute. So Kim's saying you could use the white chalk ink or the chalk pen to add some dimension to the edge of the waves. Definitely you could. Or the Misty Moonlight pad would be a great way to do that. But okay, I think the answer is overwhelmingly Poppy Parade. So we're going with a fun card. We made our detour at the end. And actually, this color of the wood grain paper matches even better inside. So, okay, let's actually stick our card together because it's flapping all over the place. I do think that the gray granite is pretty with this, but it matched better when we had our super subtle, like, nature silhouette project. And for this sort of fun cartoony project, I really like the way the Poppy Parade sets off our cartoony pirate. So there is sort of an element of Scooby-Doo in this where you have your cartoon layered over some like real life kind of grained paper. It also makes me think of the Wonder Pets if your family ever had Wonder Pets on. But so that you can kind of see this one is great here, but this is a whole different card feel. This one really loves that bright Poppy Parade so that it would really stand out. Sue says, stamp something in Poppy on the Poppy cardstock. You could totally do that if you wanted to add some background to this. I kind of like the way the frames, the like clean frame just sort of sets off and frames our artwork. So you guys remember, we went from this kind of initial design to this, which is so much better as a finished card. So hopefully the explanations along the way of following our pirate treasure map here, I have another, he can at least have treasure there. Following our pirate treasure map kind of give you that idea of how to move from point A through point B, C, D, E, F, G, whatever step we're on when we get to this one here at the end. So Oh, Carla says she really likes that flower card. Thanks, Carla. Okay, so to go along with our pirate shirt, we have our pirate card. I hope you guys have a fabulous Friday, a great weekend that includes some time for crafting. Remember that there's a little under a week to take advantage of that DSP sale that's going on. And even when you're not really like using a lot of DSP, sometimes it's just that extra little design element that is perfect. And I guess I'm going to go let Pepper out so she can go visit with those chipmunks there. She really, really wants to say hi to them. So, all right, guys, have a great weekend, and I will see you on Monday with more stamping ideas. So, happy stamping!